Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos. So, good morning everyone, good morning students. We'll be starting with the 8th chapter, the last chapter of this subject, reciprocating pumps. And we've seen centrifugal pumps. It's the second device which is used to pump water. As we saw, centrifugal pumps, it is similar to centrifugal pump, but the construction, the working principle, everything is different here. So let's go into this chapter and see what's there in reciprocating pumps. We'll start with the introduction and then we'll move into other things. So let's start with the basic introduction of this chapter. So as we saw in the last chapter, centrifugal pumps, this device is also used in certain applications where centrifugal pumps fail. So we'll see that where we use centrifugal pumps, where we use reciprocating pumps. So let's first of all understand how it works. Let's first of all understand what is the principle behind the principle involved in the working of this reciprocating pumps. So it works on the basic principle that if you want to lift a liquid or any gas from certain level to another level, so you need to increase the pressure of the liquid. So basically pump, what it does is it increases the pressure of the liquid that has to be pumped. So in this case, there'll be suppose water at certain level and there'll be pump installed, and the pump, there'll be suction created because of the piston of the reciprocating pumps, and because of suction, the water will be pulled into the pump, and after the piston moves in the other direction, the water will be pushed into the delivery side. So this is how it works. This is the basic principle involved in the working of centrifugal pumps. And there are also a lot of devices that we'll be using here. So there'll be a piston cylinder arrangement, there'll be a crank, there'll be different valves on the inlet and the outlet side, there'll be a motor which will be driving the crank. So these are the parts that will be used to manufacture the reciprocating pump, and indirectly will create a single slider mechanism that will help the water to be pumped into the pump and then into the delivery valve. So that was all about the introduction. Let's move further into this chapter. Thank you.